Welcome back, Sports Chat 503. Here with Johnny Brackets today. Getting all you guys' brackets in order. Everybody got their office pools.
Yep.
Got their this, got their that. Okay, Johnny Brackets. We're going to go through them all. 10-minute video. Listen up. Get your pens ready. Okay, Midwest is first. Yep. Who do we got in the Midwest? The big dog is Kansas.
Yep.
What do we got?
Kansas. I see them. The big upset early in the tournament is going to be UNLV over Kansas. UNLV's got a nice team.
UNLV.
Yep. They're their kind of team. I personally do not
see that happening. I'm sorry to.
No, that's fine. I
don't. Your bubble on that
yeah,
one. But
that's fine. That's why I'm Johnny Brackets and.
I'm just the other guy, right? Yeah. I'm the guy who introduces Johnny Brackets. So obviously, Johnny Brackets got some insider information. Listen up. Get your pens ready.
Yeah, no, we got. I like UNLV over Kansas, but. At the end of the day, I got Maryland playing OSU out of the Midwest.
Wow.
How about you?
Well, I like Kansas. My sleeper pick there is Michigan State. I love Michigan State every year. Mm. They bring it in the tournament. Izzo gets his team ready to play.
Yeah, Izzo's nice in the tournament.
Yeah. Lucas is a great player, a Big Ten player of the year. Dude is money, gamer down the stretch. I think that's the game of the tournament there.
Yeah.
Kansas against Michigan State in the Midwest. I also really like Ohio State because Evan Turner.
Yeah.
But I'm serious. For some reason, I like Maryland. And I think that if Maryland could upset Michigan State, then Kansas has a much easier route.
Yeah.
If Maryland or if Michigan State can beat Maryland, Michigan State could be the one to stop Kansas.
Yeah.
I really believe it.
Yeah, Maryland's got Gravis Vasquez.
Yeah, yeah.
Nice kid out of there.
Okay, what about, so I got Kansas, you have who?
Out of the Midwest. I got Ohio State.
Ohio State, I got Kansas. So the next is the West Round.
West Region.
What do you got?
West Round. I got Syracuse and K-State.
Mm.
I like K-State a lot. My sleeper pick is Vanderbilt.
Mm-hmm.
They're a good team. Check them out, guys. I got Syracuse coming out of there, though. But my big game in that one, I got a big upset. I'm taking Florida over BYU. I guess it's not huge, but Billy Donovan hasn't been in the dance a couple years.
Yeah. I'm going to go against that one. I got BYU going instead of Florida. But I think the big one there, again, Johnny Brackets,
and
I'm the other guy.
Yeah.
But again, I think my big thing is...
You're the looks.
I'm the... yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
I like Minnesota. And I like Minnesota for the fact that we have Samson III back there.
Yeah.
But I like the way that team's playing. I saw them play. Granted, it was the game that they blew out Purdue, but I just saw them play, and they look pretty good there.
Yeah, so Tubby Smith.
Yeah, I think they have an opportunity to do something and make a little noise. So I like that Pittsburgh-Minnesota game, if Minnesota can get by that first Xavier.
Yeah.
But, man, I really like K-State. If K-State can get by them, and if Pittsburgh and Minnesota, whoever goes there, that's going to be a great game as well. Syracuse, I think, could be the team to beat. I think Syracuse could end up being the number one team out of the whole thing. I don't necessarily have them. I'm huge question marks on my Final Four, but
yeah, that Boeheim zone defense in the tournament, man.
Yeah, I think defense wins, man. Defense wins. Okay, let's do the next one. I have Syracuse.
Syracuse.
Okay, we agree. Yep. Okay, the next one's the East bracket.
East round. You want to start this one off?
Yeah. I got Kentucky. I love Kentucky. I love the inside out action with the freshmen.
Yeah.
DeMarcus Cousins and John Wall, both of those guys, I think, are dicey in the tournament because you don't know what you get. They're not a proven commodity yet, but, man, they can play.
Yeah.
And if they are rolling, you just better get out the way.
Yeah, they got Coach Cal, who's been there, done that. So,
but, again, not necessarily the guy to close the deal in some of these tournaments.
Yeah, that's true. You know? Yeah, Memphis and,
But I think the game of the tournament could be that second-round matchup with Texas. Kentucky in that second round matchup could be huge. I love Damian James.
Yeah.
He is a difference maker. And I think that in the tournament, a guy like that, even though that's offensive minded, I think it could really make a difference in a game. When it's down to the stretch, it's a 2-point game, and he hits a three to win it.
Yeah, well, if Kentucky can't stop him.
Yeah, exactly.
You know,
exactly.
I mean, it's one game.
Now,
so.
I'm a huge Pac-10 honk, as you can tell. I like Washington. I think that Washington has potential. I think that Quincy Pondexter is a big man that's athletic. I think that Isaiah Thomas can score the basketball pretty much at will.
Yep.
They have a lot of other players that I think are pretty solid, but the Pac-10 is down this year, and I think it's going to sound weird, but because the Pac-10's down, you might have a Pac-10 team do well in this tournament.
Yeah.
I think Cal can play, and I think Washington can play. Mm-hmm. So I'm not saying that they're my picks necessarily, because I definitely think that West Virginia is going to smoke them in that round. But if they get past New Mexico, if they get past their first Marquette matchup, then they get past New Mexico or whoever wins that one. I think Montana doesn't have a chance. But for real.
They played the Duckies this year, Montana.
Yes, we saw them.
Yeah.
Yeah. And so the idea of the of Washington, I think, would be really fun for the Pac-10.
Yeah.
For the Northwest especially. Yep. I think there's great talent in the Northwest for basketball. There is great talent, and those guys are proof. Yep. So I got Kentucky. Who you got?
Out of the East, I got Kentucky coming out. My big the other team I really like is New Mexico. The big game, I think, in that
Steve
one is going to...
Is that the coach down there, I think?
Yeah, I think it is. Mm-hmm. Yeah, heard his name. And... Yeah. The big matchup, though, I got is the New Mexico-West Virginia game.
Ooh.
I think it's going to be an awesome game.
What do you got out of that?
I got New Mexico winning.
Wow!
But,
against West Virginia.
Yeah, and they've been pretty nice. But
West Virginia's been good.
Yeah. But
Bob Huggins.
West Virginia's, you know, not a pushover against that Kentucky team if they go through either. So
no,
but yeah, so that's what I got. And then we got the South.
Okay, so you got West Virginia coming out there?
I got Kentucky.
You got Kentucky. Okay, yeah. So we both got Kentucky coming out of the East. And then the South. Well, what do you got for the South?
I've got Duke, who's going to win NCAA National Tournament.
Again, your pick every year.
Every year.
Johnny Brackets.
Yeah, Johnny Brackets.
I think that's why you're named Johnny Brackets, because you just go with Duke. Why not? Just click the pen.
Well, yeah.
Duke.
It's like the Chris Berman 49ers Bills matchup every year. He always picks 49ers Bills because they always seem to be there. But yeah, I got Duke out of the South. Villanova's real nice. They're number two, so they're coming up from the bottom. Once you get past like Villanova and number three Baylor,
South's pretty weak.
Not a lot of competition.
South is pretty weak.
A big game that I think would be good to watch out of those, though, the Notre Dame Baylor game, because that'll you know, I don't like Notre Dame, you know, for any reason, like football, whatever they do. Just walking down the street, if you're an Irish, I don't like you.
Come on, man. No. Hey, but, for real.
Yeah. It'll be a good game, the Notre Dame.
I got Old Dominion beating the Irish. I've heard good things about Old Dominion. Wow. I heard that they're strong. I'm no expert.
Well, yeah.
That's why I have Johnny Brackets.
Johnny Brackets.
But for real, I like Siena. It could just be because they're the name that keeps coming up every year.
And plus, they're playing Purdue.
Yeah.
Who got obliterated by Minnesota. Yeah. Right.
So my whole Minnesota watching over the Purdue game has shifted two picks now. I've gone away from Purdue, and I've gone for Minnesota.
Yeah.
It's
a big upset,
it's a big swing.
In the first round.
It's a big swing.
Yeah, Siena. That's
a
good
13-4. Yeah, it's a 13-4. But I think they have the same record around there. Obviously different matchups during the regular season.
Yeah.
I love Baylor out of this one. I think Baylor has every chance to win it. I think Baylor can beat whoever they are matched up against. I have chosen Villanova at the beginning of the year as my pick. I'm going to stay with them.
Okay,
they're in it. They're still close at a two seed.
Yeah.
I thought they would actually be farther down than a two seed. I actually think that when you look at that Midwest region, some of those teams should have been in the South.
Yeah.
Georgetown. I mean,
yeah. I agree.
Yeah. So I like Nova. I've gone with it. I think Nova's going to beat Duke and... that's what I got. So I got Nova coming out of there. What do you got out of there?
I got Duke coming out because they're going to win it all.
Okay, Final Four.
Final Four. I've got the lamest Final Four picks anywhere.
Three out of the four.
Johnny Brackets. Three out of the four are number one seeds.
Yeah.
There's a reason why they're number one seeds.
Yeah, Johnny Brackets.
The other one is OSU out of the Midwest. What do you got for Final Four?
I got Kansas, Kentucky, Syracuse, and Nova. I have no idea where to go with this. I originally thought Kansas and Kentucky, but I don't think that Kentucky can meet. Or can go all the way, and I don't know if Kansas can go all the way.
Yeah. So, you, what's your, who's winning it?
Again, a correct question mark. Syracuse? I think Syracuse, man. I'm just going with my gut. I want Villanova because that was my first pick. I would like to see them win, but I think maybe Syracuse.
It's good picks. Good picks. I like Duke.
Yeah, George Mason's still in it, I think. Okay.
Yeah, no, I don't think so. Yeah, I like Duke. My sleeper pick for the tournament's Vandy. So
okay.
Hope you guys enjoy.
Good luck out there, everybody. Enjoy the madness.
Let us know how your picks go.
And try to go to work on Thursday and Friday. I know everybody tries to stay home, but your boss knows. Your boss is trying to stay home, too.
Yeah, exactly. If you don't show up, that means it's got to pull double time.
Exactly. All right, everybody. Good luck. Peace. Sports Chat 503.